It's another glorious day at Jodrell Bank, which is the University of Manchester's Centre for Astrophysics and the location of the Bluedot Festival every year. About 15,000 people here today exploring the festival, checking out the booths, eating the food, getting stuck in the mud. So let's go and meet them and see what kind of a festival they're having.
Gemma, and we're with the Doughton Nuclear Institute from the University of Manchester.
We're just here talking about graphene and all the things that it can be used for.
I'm here with the Earth and Solar System team from the university, and we've got our space rock stall in here.
I'm here with the James Webb Space Telescope. So we're showing off some of the images that we've got from Webb.
I really didn't know much about Blue Dot before coming. I just wanted to watch pavement. And then turns out, oh, it's the Massive Science Festival, brilliant.
And if people come by to your stall, what can they expect to get involved with?
We've got some Geiger counters, so you can measure radiation in everyday objects, and an atom smasher, a Lego model of a nuclear reactor, and some microbes.
We have meteorites for people to look at, samples of the moon, samples from Mars.
You can come by, peel some graphene for yourself, make some monolayers, have a look under the microscope, and chat with us about all the applications.
And here's one you prepared earlier.
A model of this sort of idea. So each of these little black spots on here are carbon atoms.
And we have got a variety of activities today, which are basically testing your physical strength. So here we have a grip strength machine.
Okay.
And we'd like to you to test your grip strength.
Okay.
Okay. Is it on?
I think so.
Yeah. Good.
All right. 3, 2, 1.
Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and stop.
Okay.
Okay, and we have 49. That's actually a really good score for a 20-year-old.
What's a typical score?
For someone around your age, it's probably around 30 kilos.
So it's a big opportunity for kids to come along and show that their parents are weaker than them.
We get some very competitive families, and it's very funny, but it's real good fun, so come along and try it out.
Present the springy majiggy. This is Mrs. Chimey Wimey, Benjamin Balathon. This is the twisty bat phones.
And you built all of these instruments that we're surrounded by?
I built all of these instruments, yes. These are my friends who I have nurtured for 10 years.
So how are you guys finding the festival? What's been your highlight so far this year?
Not mud.
Not the mud?
A band called Opina. They absolutely rocked Nebula on Friday night.
Oh, I'm sad I missed it.
A kid that came by and just absolutely fell in love with the store, wouldn't leave, wanted all the stickers.
And I bet that was probably his highlight as well.
Hopefully he'll be an astrophysicist in the future.
You never know.
It's been really great. We've had some really great crowds, particularly yesterday, despite the weather.
Someone gave me a VIP ticket for some reason.
What?
The highlight for me, I think, was being on the note stage and with Chris Hawkins. We did a talk to an audience there, a very engaged and informed audience. So
a warm shower in the morning.
Yes, very true. Are you staying here overnight and everything as well?
I am, yeah.
Just got to embrace the mud, otherwise it will embrace you.
I met Matilda Swinton.
Tilda Swinton's here?
So. She was yesterday, and I said, "Hey, Tilda, nice to meet you, I'm Dylan, how you doing? I'm going for an audition on Tuesday. Any tips?" Do you all know what a tip was?
Yeah.
Just have fun.
I just like the whole atmosphere, and you get so many different visitors. Most people don't get an opportunity to see the moon or Mars, and never mind hold it.
Very true.
Bluedot's Bluedot. It's very unique.
Can you convey your highlight of the festival so far? Yeah, music. Would you say you're more of a music fan or more of a science fan or a bit of both?
Oh, that's a tough one, that.
I'm not exactly down with the kids, so some of the music is new to me, but I'm enjoying that new music and the energy of the younger generation here, absolutely.
I think I'm equal in both, because I think one lends itself to the other quite well, personally, and I think we need that balance. We need to strike that balance of the sciences and the arts a lot more to enable creativity and innovation.
I do take inspiration from science. These instruments need a little bit of thought and physics to kind of make them.
I really like it, getting people interested and excited about science.
Yeah.
Too many people think science is hard and science is not for them.
Yeah.
It's not true. Everyone can do it.
And we've just been into a really interesting talk about the sun and the solar flares.
It was absolutely incredible. We really enjoyed the mix of the music and the science stuff. But I think the mud is what people will talk about.
Yeah.
And it's also memorable because you won't be able to get it out of all your clothes for several years.
And the tent, it'll be there forever.
Do you know why Blue Dot is so cold?
So cold.
So cold, as in why it's called Blue Dot.
Oh, right. So cold.
So freezing here.
Is it Earth? We're a little blue dot in the universe?
Pale blue dot, suspended on a sunbeam. Of course, Carl Sagan.
Little blue dot, just like Neptune. Or Uranus.
Yeah. Well, not mine. They cut out the pale bit, but they kept the blue dot.
Yeah, it
works. So I had the privilege and pleasure of meeting Carl Sagan, who coined the term the blue dot, and he came to New Zealand for Halley's Comet. I would say he's the single most important impact on my life for how I see the world.
I've got a couple of little like science-y riddles and questions for you, which you might be able to help me out with. What did Isaac Newton do?
Isaac Newton? Ooh.
By volume, how much dirt is there in a hole that measures 2 by 3 by 4 meters?
So we've got 2 times 3 times 4, so that's 12, 24 meters cubed.
It's a hole, there's no dirt at all.
Oh,
so Isaac Newton gave us...
From a scientific point of view, what is actually the best superpower to choose, given the question?
Best superpower would probably be mindfulness.
Hmm, that's a very blue dot answer.
You know Kirby?
Yeah.
Big pink ball thingy, Bobby.
Yeah.
I think the ability to be Kirby and suck up carbon from the atmosphere and...
What did the angry electron say to another atom when it got repelled? Let me at him!
Yes, lovely.
And are you currently at the University of Manchester? Are you a student?
I am, yes. Yeah, I've just finished my PhD.
Congratulations.
Yes.
Do you have any advice for any incoming, like, first year undergrads who are coming in September who don't know about university life?
Stay curious, stay imaginative, say yes to most things.
Yeah. I think the best advice I was ever given for my degree was never leave a day with something you don't understand.
Get out there and explore what the university can offer to you, and as well as all the societies, all the activities that can be done in the university.
And Manchester is a great city, so much to do, so much to see. Top tip, if you want to get to know the city, I did Scranchester food tour recently.
Scranchester, okay.
Yeah. The vulture oyster, just go for it, do it.
Do you have any advice?
Oh, for me, I would say pace yourself.
Stay sane. Work-life balance matters.
Yeah, very good advice. And finally, if you could describe Blue Dot in 3 words, what would they be?
Science, mud and music.
Eccentric.
Inspiring.
Fun. Little bit crazy.
Open-minded.
Enlightening.
Diverse.
Squelchy.
Curious.
Inspired.
Kind.
Pop.
Memorable.
Creative.
And wit.
Nice noises.
Chime.
Squelchy pop chime. Like
Squelchy
it.
Pop chime.
I like it. It's got a good ring to it, though.
Worth the mud.
Worth the mud. Yeah. Those are the 3 words. Worth the mud. Well, what a day we've had at Blue Dot today. The weather's held up. The mud has enveloped some people and never to be seen again, but they'll get over it. If you want to check out more information about Blue Dot, check out the link in the description below, and we hope to see you there next year.